4-digit 7-segment display using Arduino IDE on ES. Things we need are the 4-digit 7-segment display itself. This is a major part of our project today. And have a look at this, there's a label set to it, so I will talk about this later when we are connecting the circuit. Now, the other component that we need is obviously the Arduino Uno itself, and we need resistors, 1K resistors with a quantity of 4. We will also need some jumper cables, male to male, so that we can do the connections on our breadboard. And now finally, to connect the Arduino to our computer, we will need a USB cable. So these are all the things that we need, and finally now we can have a look at the circuit diagram. If you want to connect it using the circuit diagram, you can just pause and you can connect your circuit. Now let's look at the pinout diagram. The pinout diagram is also here for all those who can read the pin diagram. I'm not going to explain about it. If in case you need it, I will in the comments. Okay, and here are the connections. So have a look at the label side and place it on the breadboard so that the label side is facing you. Now when you place this display, now let's have a minor look at it. Okay, the bottom left side is pin number 1. So my red wire is connected to pin number 1. The next one is pin number 2, and they are all in order. So pin 3, pin 4, pin 5 and pin 6. So I have 6 pins right down on my display, bottom side of the display. Now comes the other side. So where is pin number 7? So pin number 7 is, when you flip the breadboard, is again on the leftmost bottom side again, or you can say right uppermost if in case you're connecting with the breadboard on the same side. So I connect all my pins up to pin number 12. And once I'm done connecting all my pins to pin number 12, I'm going to tell you about digit pins. Okay, so these digit pins are basically the activation pins for all my digits. So all these digits, they're represented by digit 1, digit 2, digit 3 and digit 4. So pin number 12, 9, 8 and 6 are digit pins. So now let me find pin number 12, and also let me explain how the wires should be connected so that in order you don't mess it up. So have a look, if you place it here it's good, but if you place it somewhere on the other side or over here, you might not be able to connect your resistor in a very sorted way so that you don't get confused. You can, but it will be a little bit difficult. So let me take the next pin, that is pin number 9, digit 2, and explain why it is important. So now when I place both the wires here, okay, now it gets a bit difficult, so I place it a bit on top. So there is some bit of space to connect my resistors. Now let me gather all my digit pins. So the next digit pin that I need to gather is pin number 8. So 12, 9 and 8 are done. And the last one is pin number 6. So all my digit pins are here. And I need to connect my resistors now. So let's connect our resistors to all the digit pins. So I will do them one by one. And once you are done, these resistors are connected in order to protect our displays. Okay, so they do not harm our display with the current that our Arduino gives. Okay, there you go, we are done connecting the resistors. And now let's start connecting all the pins to our Arduino. So pin number 1 goes to 1, pin number 2 again goes to pin number 2, the blue wire, okay, that is my display 2, goes to Arduino digital pin 2. If you can see that now, yeah. So now let's connect all the pins up to pin number 6. So now when we connect all my pins up to pin number 5, and I have a look at my pin number 6. Now my pin number 6 is a digit pin which is going through a resistor. So now wherever it is going through a resistor, just see that on the other end of the resistor you connect another wire. Okay. And then you connect the pin to pin digital pin 6 on the Arduino. So the connections and the numbers still remain the same, but only thing is that we are connecting the wire through a resistor. So similarly, connect pin number 7 of the display to Arduino digital pin 7, and 8 and 9 are again digit pins. Okay, in a similar way that we connected pin number 6 from the display to the Arduino digital pin 6. So pin number 7 from the display goes to Arduino digital pin 7, and 8 and 9 I said are similar to pin 6, so let's connect them through the resistor. And what is more important in this is about protecting our display. So let me tell you in a small statement that without resistors, these displays are likely to be burned out. So see that you connect the resistors, and if in case you don't connect your resistors, get ready to lose your displays. So there you go. Now I've connected pin number 8. And in a similar way, I will also connect my pin number 9. Now, I am also a bit worried about my digit pins, as they have to be carefully done. If in case I do them in the wrong fashion, or if I, misplace the wires from one side to the other, then my digit pins won't be the right digit that I need to turn on. So see that you connect them carefully, and if in case you need longer wires which are not being able to be reached to the Arduino, you can always adjust with longer wires. I'm going to do with the wires that I currently have. So I connect pin number 11 from the display to the Arduino digital pin 11, and there you go. So I have all my pins done, and the last pin is pin number 12. So that's my last digit pin that I need to connect, but it is digit 1. If you refer to the pin diagram, that's digit 1. And there you go. So you need to see that you have wires connected from 1 to 12 on the Arduino. Now connect the USB cable so that we can start programming it. And this is the code. The code is available in the description. You can click on the link and download the Arduino IDE file. Okay, it's a .ino. So here I have done some manipulations in the code, so you don't have to worry about any of the connections that you have done. So save it wherever you want to save it, and I'm going to save it as 4x4x7 segment display. Okay, and once you're done saving it, maybe you need to save it in a folder as well, since you'll be downloading the file. Compile it first, then upload. So before uploading, just check that your COM port and your Arduino is connected. So now upload the file. Once you are done uploading, you can check the output. So this is the output, and this is the code that I have written. You can manipulate the code as per your wish. If you have any suggestions, you can put it in the comments. And thank you for watching.